There are few people whom I really love, and still fewer of whom I think well. This is my family. I've never borne a resemblance to any of them. For years, I've tried to find even the smallest similarity, either in appearance or temperament, but our coloring and our cheekbones are as different as the contours of our hearts. Despite the confusion and isolation that comes with youth, and from being human in general, my Nanna always had a way to bring my worried mind back home. She was my favorite person, and she died a year ago. I miss her very much. Though I'm the proverbial black sheep in the family, I always tried to copy her. I still do. She's my ideal. And I was her favorite. I know I shouldn't say things like that, but my Nanna always spoke her mind, and so in my continued attempts to emulate her style, I'll be a little bold. I was her favorite. I know this implicitly. Granted, there wasn't much competition, only 6 other grandkids besides myself. But I was the lucky one who got to live with her. My cousins never knew about her slumber ship lullaby, or where she hid her chocolates. They didn't dance with her while listening to old records from the 1940s, and none of them had their very own fruit nickname. Nanna called me her peach, and I loved her for it. I am so grateful for the life I got to share with her, but I'd give anything for more time. I can't remember a point in my life when she wasn't with me. This first year without her has been my most lonely. I'm still trying to figure out this whole how to be a grown-up thing, and I can't ask her for advice. Okay, to be honest, Nanna really didn't know how to give me good advice. She was always simple, straightforward, and slightly out of touch. But she really blatantly loved me. That was enough. It hasn't really sunk in that I'll never see her again. I've lived away from my home for so long now that I just can't quite grasp the permanence of her death. I just picture her waiting at home for me to come back for a visit. And when I try to reason it out, it just leaves me feeling empty. She'll never see me marry, and she'll never hold my babies. I can't explain what I'm studying and writing to her anymore. I know she didn't really understand it, but she always listened, and she cared when no one else did. I want more time. I want more memories. But I'm so grateful for how much of Nanna I've had in my life. I'll never forget.